when you dip into the corkscrew, that was not there from the beginning. That was something we added later on because one of the enthusiasts said, well, you know, I think that star is too boring. My name is Andreas Andersen. I am the CEO here at Liseberg since 3 years. This project is actually a project which has been in the making for about 4 years. I've been working here 3 years, so it's a project that I took over from my predecessor here at Liseberg. But I would say a year and a half into that process, we decided to restart it. We were afraid that this coaster would be too large, too dominant. And we also had some noise issues we had a tough time solving with that project. So we restarted it and came up with this layout, which is a double launch 7 inversion coaster that keeps lower to the ground but still has a considerable length and also lots of different experiences. It starts with a dip into a corkscrew. So when you exit the station and you're sitting on the last row, you're already, you know, screaming, basically. Then it does another corkscrew, has a winding track down to the bottom of the hill because the ride is placed on a hill. We do a pretzel loop, a zero-G roll, airtime hill, a dive into a helix, and then we have a second launch taking the ride back to the station with an inverted top hat, which is behind me here, and airtime hill, track and a hardline roll to end the whole experience just before the brakes. You know, when you hit the second launch, you've actually had a full coaster experience. You've been head over heels 5 times, you've had a launch, you've had 2 airtime hills, you've had a nice helix. And then when the second launch hits you, it's bam, and then you go again. When we got the first layouts of the ride, which were really great, you know, we circulated them, you know, to a couple of select coaster enthusiasts. Ask them, you know, what do you think of this? And they came back with you know, several suggestions. One of them is actually the start of the ride, and we made it work. So I would say it's not just a product of Mack or Stengel or Liseberg. It's very much also a product of all the coaster nerds out there. I think a good coaster has sort of the same characteristics as a good film or a piece of music. It has an introduction, it has a crescendo, it has sort of a build up and then it sort of fades out. We want a ride which kept your attention throughout the course of the track, and I think we pretty much succeeded with that. I'm a lawyer, but I'm also a lawyer that spent most of my free time and my money on traveling around the world, visiting parks. I mean, I try to, you know, keep myself updated. So I visit the biggest European enthusiast sites, you know, theme park enthusiasts. They're your biggest fans, but they're also your hardest critics. So they, you know, they'll tell it like it is to you, and that I enjoy. And I've actually been very often to Loopings. I actually understand most of it because, you know, when you as a Dane, when you read Dutch, you understand, I would say, 80% of it. So I understand both the good and the bad.